Guys of Reddit, what are some weird things that almost every girl does, but they don't realize?
Most of the girls I've been with complain about feeling cold all the time, but when they are asleep it's like they go into oven self-clean mode, and I need to scoot away. Not especially cold during the day, but I regularly wake up absolutely drenched in sweat, with clothes that are visibly wet. Not fun. When it's picture time they all strike a very specific pose. Usually it's subtle, like a hand on the hip or a slight tilt of their head or something, but it's automatic and kinda funny to see happen in real time. The one leg bent and the other leg straight pose. A beveled leg pose. Shower at near boiling level temperatures. It's the only way to combat how perpetually cold we feel. My BF whenever I'm cold happens when women are too far from home, insinuating how he thinks he is hilarious. Every time. Stealing my clothes. Every GF/FB I've ever had made off with at least one piece of my clothing. Girls always know how to spot your fav shorts/hoodie/t-shirt too. I wish they stole the stuff I don't wear. How can they notice them if you don't wear them? I guess I should say less often. My sister has a box of hoodies and sweaters that boys let her borrow and she never returned. Puts them into a box, at least wear them then. Moving your things, forgetting they moved your things, then telling you they didn't move your things. I bought us a second set of tweezers, since she kept taking them to her car, and leaving them in said car. There are now currently two pairs of tweezers in her car. Cool. Please find out how many tweezers your wife can squirrel away in her car. For the science. A quick search found bulk tweezers for $0.39 each on AliExpress. Make us proud. In 5 months, when you actually get them. The Express stands for the expressions of rage you will feel as you wait. The dolphin they tied the package to did a really good job swimming across the Pacific. Stop giving it such a hard time. Women only buy tweezers and tweezers at Harman. That's a scientific fact. And you're not allowed to borrow any of them for your nose or ears. It's like every woman was an incompetent squirrel in their prior life. Chitters and throws acorns. Yes dear. Try to pretend they didn't just fart. Farts you. What's with that? Them? What was what? Barking spiders are an epidemic in my house. Barking spiders. We'll definitely use that one next time. There's a bar in Cleveland called the Barking Spider. Wonder if that's the origin? I have carpet frogs. The struggle is real. Sometimes it's a duck in the house. Say no, they don't want any food/drink item that you offered them, then proceed to eat half of yours. Ranting about a particular food being too salty or sweet or oily, but proceeds to eat it. Ugh, this thing is so unhealthy. Why do they even make this? It should be banned. My aunt to a T. She visited us from overseas a couple of weeks ago, and we took her to several restaurants for dinner. Every single meal we had with her, the conversation would go like this. Mum, the food here is great. I'm really in the mood for, insert dish here, aunt. Disapproving sniff. The menu looks nice, but you can never tell how much butter/oil/salt they are putting into your meal at restaurants. I'll just have a salad. Proceeds to eat half of the food off everyone else's plate after dinner. Aunt, that was so unhealthy. I'll have to fast for 3 days now, otherwise I'll get so fat. They fart in their sleep, a lot probably from all of that not farting during the day stuff. Float a quarter of an inch off of the ground when exceptionally excited. Same but, only when I'm lying face down. Outstanding move. Cha-cha real smooth. You made such a sacrifice today. It will not be forgotten. Play with your hair constantly. Bring themselves down for the littlest reasons. They can be physically flawless and still they'll be like, no, have you seen? Insert tiny indistinguishable flaw that you would never have noticed unless they pointed it out. I'm so ugly. Well, excuse me Jessica, but if your literally goddess looking face is ugly, then what the fuck do you call the monstrosity that is my face? The last time my girlfriend told me she's fat, I googled fat and proceeded to show her that no, she's not fat at all. Made her giggle. Did this with a very good friend who said she had saggy tits. Not that I mind saggy tits. It's just that hers aren't. Buys new sexy swimsuit for summer, or motivation to get in shape for summer. Never actually wears a new swimsuit, even though it looks totally fine. or covers it with a t-shirt and shorts. I get wanting to look slash feel sexy, and I get modesty, but I don't understand covering up sexy outerwear to hide it away. They felt confident when they bought it slash put it on, but lost that confidence when they went out in public, where it'd be seen by tons of others, and compared to all the other girls' sexy swimsuits and bodies. It's not that hard to understand. Tells their partner they can pick a place to eat, then says no to every place they pick. My wife and I do the 3-2-1 method. One of us picks 3 things, then the other narrows it down to 2, and then the other makes the final choice. We use it pretty much every day for almost anything you can think of. I just explained the 3-2-1 method to my wife, and I asked her if she wanted to watch John Wick 300 or Inglourious Basterds. Her response was fuck that bullshit. Where do you want to go for dinner? I don't know. You choose. Shall we go to X? No. How about Y? No. Z maybe? No. Alright then. Where do you want to go? I don't know, that's why I'm asking you to choose. I once named 15 places and my wife said no to every single one of them. And then I get blamed for not choosing a place. Since then, if she can't choose a place, I just drive to where I want to eat. My wife has a double threat kind of deal with this. After the usual where shall we eat? Anywhere, I don't care. Okay, steak. No, not steak. She'll eventually decide that she definitely wants Chinese. But then you have to decide which Chinese. And then when she's settled on one, this happens. Oh well, probably China Red, but hang on, that's really expensive. So we should probably just go and get steak if we are spending that much. But I really wanted squid. Does anywhere that isn't Chinese do squid? That Greek place does, but all their mains are shit. What if we just get Thai instead? Because they do squid, but then their mains are huge, so you don't really need a starter. 9 times out of 10 this lengthy debate ends up with us eating fish and chips on the beach instead. Adjust tits. Not complaining, but a lot of girls I see have done it non-discreetly and get an entire hand down there. I guess it's hard to adjust the chestnuts secretly, obviously, but I find it odd barely any get embraced when anybody sees them do it. Gonna repeat. Not complaining. The bigger they are, the more difficult they become to manage. You have to adjust your balls regularly, and they're pretty small. Can you even imagine? Have giant sacks of fat on your chest that jiggle all over the place. And yes, putting a whole hand in there is often necessary. It is called the boob scoop. Tit happens. Say something in a completely indirect way with the expectation that your male brain will be able to deduce the meaning. Don't put that thing there. Put it over there in that thingy. Love you, mum, but I'd gladly strangle you. When you get pissed, I can't get your meaning. Getting full after eating a meal, but if I mention dessert, all of a sudden there is space again for it. Also, when asked what's the problem, it's almost always nothing as a reply. It's because we have a second stomach specifically meant for dessert slash sweets. The first definitely isn't a girl thing. Did you not know boys have an ice cream stomach too? Also, the latter is probably just not wanting to bother people. Also not a girl only thing. Desserts go to the soul, not the stomach. Common knowledge. That's because dessert is good. I'm going to be full anyway, so I might as well top everything off with a chocolate cream pie. What I don't understand is how women can pour hot wax on their bodies, let it dry, then rip out every single hair by its root and still be scared of spiders. Jerry Seinfeld. Whisper to their friends about you right in front of you. You say something, they whisper, and it's always in front of you. Yeah, and it isn't fucking slick at all. I had a friend talking shit about me, just unnecessary mean shit, to another actual mutual friend, right in front of me. Just whispering into her ear, like I can't hear her sitting 2 feet away. What the fuck? Going to the toilet in groups. I tried to do this as well, but my friends get mad when I crawl under the stall door to join them. You're supposed to hold their wang out of the way for them. That's what women do when they go in there together. Like that scene with the clown zombie in Zombieland. Bro, leave some toilet paper, my shit gonna be nasty. I have to pee. The fact that they need to go isn't weird, but almost every girl I've ever met seems to feel like they're required to announce to everyone in the room when they're going to the bathroom and what they're doing in there. Misplace every hair tie they own. then complain about not having any hair ties, and go buy more, only to complain about not having any hair ties a few days later.